pain is not in the nerves, it's actually in your head. A great example of this is war stories where soldiers have had a really major injury, but they're able to walk off the battlefield and only realize later that the extent of their injury. And this is actually controlled through pathways from the brain that basically suppress pain from ascending up into the brain. Part of our work has changed to actually look at not the input into the system, but how the brain actually modifies the input.
Pain modulation is super fascinating because depending on their circumstances, it changes how we perceive pain. We're studying a region in the brain, part of the medulla, that descends directly onto the spinal cord that is involved in descending pain modulation.
The work in our group relates to a number of diseases in the oral cavity, in particular trigeminal neuralgia and TMJ, which is a temporal mandibular joint disease. Both of these lead to persistent chronic pain. A lot of the treatments that are available aren't effective.
I find perception extremely fascinating and how it differs from individuals and between individuals. I'm trying to understand how different populations of neurons can either increase or decrease that pain. And with that manipulation, we can hopefully suppress pain in the future, especially for people who have chronic pain.
We're starting to know the cell types that respond to painful stimuli versus the ones that respond to, for instance, innocuous stimuli like warmth and touch. But we're also equally knowing the neurons that are actually involved in itch. We use a number of different techniques to try to look at different genes and molecules that are important. We use procedures like immunohistochemistry, which is a way to stain for proteins that are present in individual cells. We also look at a set of molecules called the RNA, which are transcribed from genes and then can be translated into the protein.
On some days, I can come in and do surgeries on mice to specifically target different molecular populations of neurons in these mice. And then on other days, I could do behavior testing to see how these animals respond to different noxious stimuli. And then on other days, I can also do anatomy, take a look at what neurons are overlapping with other populations.
We use this method called confocal microscopy, and this is just really a technical way that we can get a very sharp focus on an image. It uses a laser. This allows us to see in really fine detail to individual cells. And very often we'll stain a certain molecule in one cell versus another cell in different colors. So for instance, red and green. And if we actually see there's not an overlap, we'll see individual colored cells, a red cell and a green cell. If it happens that they're together, then this will be a mixing and we'll see a yellow cell.
Pain is a very broad term. And with the opioid epidemic, we know that we need very specific drug targets to have specific effects that don't have long-lasting or severe side effects.
We would like to try to identify the components and new targets to actually be able to treat those in a rational way.